ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय
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 अपि
अपि
न
न
सुहृदा
सुहृदा
आत
आदा
बान्धवा
बान्धवा
कृष्णदेवता
कृष्णदेवता
दृष्टा
दृष्टा
श्रुता
श्रुता
वा
यादव
यादव स्वपुर्यां
स्वपुर्यां
सुखं
सुखं
वासते
वासते
अपि न सुहृदा
अपि न सुहृदा
आत
आत
बान्धवा कृष्णदेवता
बान्धवा कृष्णदेवता
दृष्टा श्रुता
दृष्टा श्रुता
वा यादव
वा यादव
स्वपुर्यां
स्वपुर्यां
सुखमासते
सुखमासते
अपि न सुहृदस्तात
सुहृदस्तात
बान्धवा कृष्णदेवता
बान्धवा कृष्णदेवता
दृष्टा श्रुता
दृष्टा श्रुता
वा यादव
वा यादव
सुपुर्यां
सुपुर्यां
सुखमासते
सुखमासते
अपि न
अपीना
सुहृदस्तात
सुहृदस्तात
बान्धवा कृष्णदेवता
बान्धवा कृष्णदेवता
दृष्टा श्रुता
दृष्टा श्रुता
वा यादव
वा यादव
सुपुर्यां
सुपुर्यां
सुखमासते
सुखमासते
अपि
अपि
वेदर
वेदर
नः
नः
आवर
आवर
सुहृदः
सुहृदः
well wishes
tat
tat
oh my uncle
bandava
bandava
friends
friends
krishna devata
krishna devata
those who are always wrapped in the service of lord shri krishna
those who are always wrapped in the service of lord shri krishna
drishta
drishta
by seeing them
by seeing them
shruta
shruta
or by hearing about them
or by hearing about them
va
va
either
either
yadavah
yadavah
the descendants of yadu
the descendants of yadu
swapurya
swapurya
along with their residential place
along with their residential place
sukhamasate
sukhamasate
if they are all happy translation my uncle you must have visited Dvaraka. In that holy place, there are our friends and well-wishers, the descendants of Yadu, who are always wrapped in the service of Lord Shri Krishna. You might have seen them or heard about them. Are they all living happily in their abodes?
Apina sridastata bandhava krishna devata drishtya sutava jadava sapujyang sukamasata The Yudhishthira Maharaj, after meeting Vidura, the first inquiry was about the family of Krishna. That is Krishna consciousness. He was always thinking of Krishna. Now, because he has come back home by touring different places of pilgrimage, Dwarka is also one of the celebrated place of pilgrimage. So he expected that Vidura must have gone to Dwarka. And when he had gone to Dwarka, he must have some news from Krishna's place. So Krishna is a friend, intimate friend of the Pandava. Therefore he says, No, no means our. Suhida. Suhida, this word, always thinking of others' good, that is called Suhida. The heart is not contaminated. Hida means heart. And Su means very good. So Krishna says also that Suhida Sarvabhutana. And here, Yudhishthira Maharaj confirms, not Suhida. Actually, Krishna is Suhida. Suhida means well-wisher. as the father is the well-wisher of the sons, or intimate friend, well-wisher. Here in the material world, although I may be your well-wisher, you may be well-wisher, but there is some interest. Unless there is some interest for my personal benefit, I cannot become your suhida. This is material suhida. But spiritual suhida is different. Spiritual suhida means everyone is suffering for want of spiritual consciousness, Krishna consciousness. Therefore, attempt should be made so that everyone becomes Krishna conscious. That is spiritual suhida. We are now entangled. Actually, our position in this material existence is not very good. Everyone sees it practically, still they want to adjust. Let us make it good. Let us make it. That is called punapunacharvitacharvana. Again and again chewing the chew. Just like generally a father, especially in India, he wants that his son may be well situated. Therefore we don't get Indian youth very much. Because the father and mother settles them. What is that? Get them married and give them some earning capacity, either by service or business. So he becomes satisfied. This is the end of life. Grihamedhi. Just now I am married, it is my duty to stick to the griha and enjoy senses. That's all. Grihamedhi. Sacrifice for Krishna, brahmachari, sannyasi. Sannyasis have become rogues, and there is no brahmachari, not vanaprastha. Therefore, it is very difficult to get Indian workers. They have no. Your qualification is, I told in the beginning, that you have got a renouncing spirit. That is a great qualification. Tyaga. Renunciation is opulence also. Krishna, six opulences. One of the opulences is renunciation. Aishat jasya samagrasya bhijasya jasya sriya jnana vairagya. Vairagya means renunciation. You have enough of this material enjoyment. You have enjoyed. Or you have seen that there is no actually profit. Therefore, you are in a spirit. That is natural. That is natural. If one has enjoyed very much, the next stage will be renunciation. This is natural. So, because you have got a renouncing spirit, you are understanding or taking Krishna consciousness very nicely. At least very eagerly. Jnana vairagya, that is required. This vairagya then. I therefore sometimes like these hippies because they have a spirit of renunciation. That is a very good position. Simply they require jnana or knowledge. Then their life will be successful. To bring one to the platform of renunciation, that's a very difficult job. Especially when one has got nice wife, nice home, nice bank balance. It is very, very difficult. So, there is a version by Krishna that one who is anxious to take Krishna consciousness, but he is entrapped with this binding, nice wife, nice children, nice home, nice bank balance. So, Krishna, in order to give them, give such devotee facility, he takes her. Harishe tad dhanam janai, jasyaham anuginnami, harishe tad dhanam janai. Just like he did with the Pandavas. The Pandavas were devotees, but at the same time, they were king, their attachment. So therefore Krishna took away their everything, their kingdom, their wife, their position, their honor, taste, and still they did not give up Krishna, therefore they came out victorious. So Krishna sometimes tastes, that's how much one devotee is. He forcibly makes him a renounce in order. That is Krishna's special favor. So, this vairagya jnana, it is required. We are discussing the last night also. Vitaraga vayakrut. These things are required. Unless one becomes completely, what is called, averse?
Detached.
So, what is this nonsense material life? That's a very good qualification. If one understands this perfectly, this is all rubbish, this material enjoyment. It's a great qualification. Akinchan. Akinchan. Akinchan means do not possess anything material. Akinchana gocharam. Queen Kunti, when he was receiving Krishna, she said, "My dear Krishna, you are akinchana gocharam. You are realized by a person who has no material position. And you have given us now so much material position, how we can understand you?" That was Kunti was regretting. That when we are in distress, you are always with us. Now you have given us kingdom and everything. Now we are going away to Dwarka. What is this, Krishna? Better let us go to again to that distressed condition so that you may remain with us. Akinchana gochara. Krishna is akinchana gochara. Anyone who wants to enjoy material life, it is not possible to become fully Krishna conscious. This is very secret. Therefore Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, Niskinchanas Bhagavad Bhajan Ol Mukhas. Bhagavad Bhajan, to become devotee, Krishna conscious, is meant for niskinchanasya, one who does not possess anything in the material. That does not mean he should be poverty stricken. No. He should know it fully, that nothing belongs to me, everything belongs to Krishna. I am simply his servant. This is called akinchana. If I think by keeping Krishna in front, I let me possess some material things, that is another cheating. That is not. You should be fully conscious that everything belongs to Krishna and nothing to us. Then Krishna becomes your Srihida. He takes charge. How your benefit will be there, ultimately. Tesham satadhyuktanam bhajatam pritipurvagam dadam pritipurvagam. This is very great determination. Krishna, I simply want you. Nothing else. Na dharang na janang na sundaring kavitang va jagadish. This is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's teaching. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has taught this philosophy. Repeated. Niskinchanasya, Bhagavad Bhajan. Bhagavad Bhajan means he himself became Niskinchan. He was Krishna himself, most opulent. Taktas, Surepsitas, Sudushtaja Surepsita Rajala King. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had the most beautiful wife, goddess of fortune, Vishnu Priya, Lakhi Priya, but for the benefit of the whole world, although He is Krishna. He showed us the example. At the age of 24 years, he took sannyas. He was not unhappy in his home. He had his very affectionate mother and some like affectionate mother and most affectionate wife, beloved wife. But still, it is very difficult to renounce the affection of mother and love of wife. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu did it. The fly is still disturbing. So, tattva sudustaja. Therefore, in the Bhagavad it is said, sudustaja, very difficult to give up. The fan is good. Tattva sudustaja surepsita rajala king. And rajala king, such nice, beautiful wife, desired even by the demigod. Such a nice wife. Takvas Surev Sita Sudustaja Surev Sitarajila King Dhanmishta Arjavatasa Jadagadaranam Jat Ja Agat Arannam. To Arannam means going to the forest means to take sannyas. Going to the Himalaya does not mean, or going to the forest does not mean that he should actually go there. One should give up this family affection and dedicate the whole life for Krishna's service. That is really going to the forest. Not that unnecessarily. It may be beneficial for person, for his personal self, but real renunciation is to have no more interest in so-called limited jurisdiction of family, social, international, national, but the whole interest is for Krishna. That is real renunciation. That is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Renunciation does not mean give up this world. That I was explaining. Our philosophy is not, the jagat is mithya. Why jagat mithya? We don't say that. Jagat is fact. It may be temporary, but it is a fact. Now, so long we have got this jagat, let us utilize it for Krishna. That is renunciation. We cannot say this microphone is mithya. So long the microphone is in my possession, let it be used for Krishna's service. This is renunciation. Everyone using this microphone, these modern machines, for his personal gain. But we are not using for personal gain. We are traveling all over the world, spending so much money, jet plane and this plane, just to push Krishna consciousness as much as possible. This is renunciation. Not that sitting one place doing nothing and become Krishna conscious, then they will fall down. Don't imitate Haridas Thakur. That is not possible. We must fall. So, to such person, Krishna is Surida. Surida, as it is said, Apina Surida, Stata, uncle, Bandhava, Krishna Devata. Krishna Devata, when one who has accepted Krishna as the worshipable deity, he is called Krishna Devata. There are so many demigods they have taken to worship. The Romans were worshipping demigods. In India, they also worship demigods. That will not make you happy. Antavatta phalam tesha tad bhavati alpa medhasa. to take some benediction from the demigods. Although people go there, kankantang karmanang siddhing jajanti iho devata. People are very much attached to enjoy this material world, so they worship Durga, Kali, or Lord Shiva, kankantang karmanang siddhi. They get immediately some material benefit. But tad bhavati alpamedasam. What do you do with some temporary material benefit? That is the instruction of Krishna. Don't be attracted by the temporary material benefits. Just try for permanent, eternal benefit. Go back to home, back to God. That is it. That is it. What will you do? Suppose you become king. How long will you remain king? Or there are so many dangers. Sometimes the kings are beheaded. King John was beheaded. So, material position is always tilting. Yes, it is. There is no fixed position. It will end. Therefore, Krishna says, antabhattu phalam tesha. Antabhat means it will end. Today or tomorrow or 100 years after. It will end. So why should you? You are eternal. Why should you hanker after these things which will exist for some few years? You are eternal. Accept the eternal position. There is Krishna consciousness movement. Eternal position. So, for that eternal position, you have to make Krishna Devata. Krishna is the worshipable divinity. Krishna is eternal, and if you fix up your service to Krishna, then Krishna will accept you as servant, naturally you become eternal. There is a very nice story. Nice story, not a fact. Savitri Satyavan. Savitri Satyavan. Incidences are mentioned in the shastras to give us lesson. Savitri was a very chaste, devoted woman. Savitri. In India, to the woman, in order to become very chaste and devoted to husband, they observe the ritualistic ceremony to worship Savitri, Satyavan. You see, Savitri was in love with a boy, was destined to die on the marriage day. But still she married. She knew that as soon as I will be married, and the same day my husband will die. So, she pleased the Jamaraj. After the death, the husband died, but she pleased the Jamaraj. So much so, that Jamaraj was ready to give her some benediction. So Jamaraj said, what benediction you want? As a woman, I wish that maybe a son of mine from me. All right, you will get a son. Then again she said that if you are taking away my husband, I will get my son. So her husband was made alive. Indirectly. Krishna Devata, if you actually want to be eternally blissful, take to Krishna Devata. There is no need of praying for make me immortal. No. If you accept Krishna Devata, then automatically, just like the benediction was, you will get a son. Automatically her husband was made alive. So Krishna Devata. So Yudhishthira Maharaj asking, did you see them? the Jadu families who have Krishna as their worshipful deity. Drishta Sutava Jadava. Jadu. Jadava is plural number. Sapujjan Sukamasate. Whether they are happy and in their home, Sapujjan, Sapuri, Dwarka. So in this way, Krishna consciousness means always thinking of Krishna and make Krishna the friend. Krishna says that Suidam Sarvabhutan, actually Krishna is the only friend. And he is sitting in everyone's heart. He is so nice friend that he is simply trying to induce us to turn our face towards Krishna. He is coming as avatar, incarnation. He is giving us advice from the within. The Sarvadharman Parityajya Mamekam Saranam Vraja. He is such a nice friend. Although we have left Krishna, Krishna has not left us. Yes, he is living with me within my heart to give me advice. Please come back. Sarvadharman Parityajya Mamekam. So Krishna is so nice friend. He is such a nice friend that even to the enemy, he gives the greatest benediction. Just like Putana. Putana came to kill Krishna, smearing poison on her breast. But Krishna gave her promotion on the motherly platform. Krishna is so grateful that this demon might have come to me to poison me. But I have sucked her breast. She has become my mother. Therefore, she must get the position of my mother. Krishna is so great. If you give little service to Krishna sincerely, Krishna will never forget you. And he's so powerful. If Krishna becomes your friend and Krishna remembers you, then what do you want more? Just imagine. That's for Krishna. It is says, Krishna Devata. Fix up your mind in Krishna and be happy. Thank you.